Hey guys, and welcome back to the next video. Today we want to take a look at our war Tribe Gaming versus WHF. Yes, it says Tribe Academy, but it was pretty much Tribe Gaming because we had not enough players to play in both clans, so we decided to play in Tribe Academy since, well, you can't really achieve anything this season, so that's why we decided, okay, let's play in Tribe Academy, push the clan level a little bit, and then we can play the Champions War League Elite in Tribe Gaming. That was the plan. We faced WHF and won with 10 stars more, 10 triple more, which was really nice. I will show you a couple of attacks from this war. I won't show you too much because, well, we don't want to burn any of the base of WHF. So in total, I will show you 2 attacks. And after that, we will talk a little bit more about the World Championship of Clash of Clans. And yeah, this is going to be it for this video. So let's take a look at the first replay, which is going to be on the number 10 guy from Eve Check. And this is going to be a really nice queen charge with earthquakes, which isn't like that usual to do, but on this way it worked really well. So what is the goal pretty much? He's going in between of 2 inferno towers. He's using the earthquake right in between, and then he's trying to push into the core of this base. This means he will not only get the 2 inferno towers, he will get as well the 1 air defense in between. And obviously he will get the enemy queen, he will get the eagle, and he has access to most of the expos on this side, which is super important as well. And as soon as all of the stuff around the eagle is cleared, he has really nice pathing into the town hall, which is always super important when you do those Lalo attacks versus those bases when you're in the clan war league, because you never want to risk it 1 star pretty much, or even 0 star. So you always have a plan for the town hall. So let's take a look how he's dealing with the enemy CC. One thing which is really nice, he's out of range of all of the other expos, only 1 expo shooting at his queen, which means it's not enough damage for actually taking her down, which means he only has to use the rage spells and nothing like, well, the queen ability, etc. So he can save that for later for the enemy expos. Like I said, there's going to be a really crucial thing later in this attack. But now he's starting off with this Lalo. He's early using the loons, and as well, keep an eye onto those minions, trying to pick up a couple of more percentages to activate the town hall to make sure that he's actually getting all of the value he wants to get. The loons onto the Tesla farm, and now, yeah, kind of the big mistake. Using the warden ability too early because of the tornado trap, but because he took already out 3 out of 3 multi-inferno towers, and there are nearly no wizard towers left which actually can shoot his big portion of loons, because like the other 2 loons are tanking over there. This means it won't really matter that most of his loons are nearly dead, so that's a nice thing. And this is going to be a huge overkill. Minions in the end will clean everything up, and this is going to be a crazy, crazy 3-star for Eve check. Then, like I said, I want to show you guys 2 attacks, so we will take a look at the second one, which is going to be on number 5. After that, like I said, we will take a look at the World Championship. So, the next attack is from Boom, crazy good attacker, I guess you guys know him, and what he's trying to do, he's trying to actually push into this long compartment to take out all of the stuff which is around there, and then we'll jump to the enemy queen. That's basically the plan, so let's take a look how he's doing it. He's not using the healers too early because it's always risky when you're trying to charge into a pretty much the air defense, which means you always run the risk of the healer switching. So he's delaying the healers, which was super nice, and this means the healers will stay on his queen. Now, even though his king went inside, which wasn't part of the plan, he still has no healer switch, which means everything is going smooth. Now he's using a rage spell just to make sure that he's going quicker through the enemy hound, because he has a lot of spells left. This means he just wants to speed things up. He wants to get faster through the hound. Otherwise, it could cause a time issue. You guys saw maybe in the beginning, this attack was really close on time. So super important that he's actually speeding things up. Next rage to make sure that his queen is not dying. Loon on the outside to take care of the Tesla, which normally should have The king should have done that, but hey, now the loon was supposed to do that, even though it's not working. And one more thing to notice, he's using the freeze to make sure that he's saving the queen ability. Like Eve check did, right now when you're doing those queen charges, try to save your queen ability, and if you have the spells to bring pretty much, try to bring a freeze spell just to make sure that you save your queen ability for later stages of the attack. Like he's doing right here to take out, for example, the Inferno Tower and a couple of other buildings as well. Now he's coming in with the Lalo as well, using a freeze onto the Multi-Inferno Tower. The Tornado Trap is a little bit annoying. Now he's countering the Tornado Trap pretty much with his own Warden ability. And there's not that much left anymore. And you guys saw as well, one super important thing is, if you guys know that you're facing good opponents, like WHF or other really good clans, try to concentrate more on air than on ground, because even though Hawks kind of look completely overpowered right now, maybe, air is stronger, which means air, if you have a good plan with the air composition, like Lalo for example, it's safer, because when you're running into a lot of spring traps, you as an attacker have no chance to counter that. If you're running into, like, I don't know, all of the spring traps of the enemy, you have no chance to counter that with the Hawk Riders. Meanwhile, when you're running into the Tornado Trap or, I don't know, like air traps in general with your air attack, you still have a lot of stuff on how to counter that with good performance, like good loon drops, good, I don't know, hound drops, whatever. So always try to choose air over ground, because it is how it is. It's harder, but it's better. So this is going to be the two replays I'm showing you for now. I will probably do like a recap of the week as well after the week, to not burn like too many bases or anything. Those were the two bases we wanted to take a look at. And as well, this was one of the reasons why I showed one of the attacks of Boom. We had a change in our roster for the World Championship, because Tribe announced that yesterday on Twitter. I thought I would throw it into today's video as well. So what is going to happen? In the rulebook, it says that every single team has the chance to up to two players and change that in their roster. Since out of the rosters are only five players, you can't really have like any extra players, which is, well, one flaw in the rulebook or like in the tournament itself, but let's put it there. We decided to change two players, and this is going to be Vale and Boom joining the team. Meanwhile, Zebix and Mutki going pretty much on the bench, which means they're not leaving Tribe or anything. They're just not anymore in the five-man roster. You guys know we're playing as Tribe Gaming already for quite some time, and it's not only the five players who are in the team, which means there are way more players in behind who are working with base building, who are helping, and many other things. So it's always a team effort, and only the five players, well, they will in the end do the attacks. So we decided, okay, for the World Championship, this is the best move for the team, and that was pretty much the reason behind that. I wanted to throw it out there because I saw like a lot of comments on Twitter about that, so I thought it would be nice to pick it up for the video. If you guys think like I don't know, We're super grateful for everything what Zebix and Mutki did for the team. And we had like a really long talk as well with all of the guys together. But like I said, we thought, like all of us thought together, that this would be the best decision or like the best lineup for the Clash World Championship. And this means basically we have Eve Jack, Eve Maxi, Vale, Boom, and me, who will represent Tribe Gaming in the World Qualifier. And yeah, we have to face one of the world of the wildcard teams, where one of these spots might go to WHF, which means we have overall six teams which will go to Hamburg for sure, who qualified over the last 6 months. Which means we have, for example, Tribe Gaming, Team Kesso, Vatang, Queenwalkers, MCS, and now in the last qualifier, Nova. All of those teams will make it to Hamburg 100%, but it means there are two teams missing. Those teams will get determined by the community, which means there will be eight clans handpicked by Supercell. No one knows pretty much how, like, what is the criteria on how to get picked, or like what is happening. I guess Supercell will tell that in a bit, because Hamburg is getting closer and closer, so that should happen pretty soon. And this means, well, we will have the possibility to vote pretty much. And one of those 8 spots is already, well, basically went for WHF, because they won the Champions War League Elite Division, which, the admins and Supercell had a deal or something like that, where the winner will take one of the wildcard voting spots. They're not yet like qualified, or like, it doesn't mean that they will go for sure to Hamburg, but you guys have the possibility to vote for them, and we have to wait pretty much for Supercell to pick the rest of the clans. I'm super excited because, like I said, one of those clans will face us in the first round. It's going to be an amazing match. I can't wait for that. And yeah, I hope you guys liked the video. I will see you guys in the next one. See you guys. Bye bye.